Radio OUM, roaming across your mind. Assalamualaikum and good morning everyone. Thank you for choosing iRadio OUM as your favorite internet radio station. And now you're with me, Fatin, in this segment, Let's Learn English. Okay, let me introduce our special guest today, Mr. Zakia Zainal Ozek. Hi Zak, how are you today?
Hello Fatin, good morning.
Hello, good morning Zak. And we have Siti Hazra here.
Yes.
Hi Siti Hazra.
Hi, good morning.
Okay Zak, so maybe you can share a little bit about our segment for this semester, July.
Okay. Hello, listeners, and welcome to this episode, Learning English with Zak. These 10 episodes will share with you various aspects of English. And I'd just like to quote this quotation from Oprah Winfrey, yeah? And one of my favorite quotes. And this is what she said. Now, you cannot be what you want to be by remaining who you are today. Mm-hmm. So that is so very true, ladies. Isn't that true?
It's true.
Okay, so what it says is that we got to do something, some kind of action to mm-hmm. get results. So just like speaking English, if you want to be more confident and not to feel ashamed or embarrassed to speak the language, you got to start somewhere. Mm-hmm. So let's start speaking English from today onwards, yeah, ladies?
And also, yeah. Practice makes perfect.
Yeah, but just before that, let me say hello to my fellow students, yeah? Razif, I hope all of you are tuning in. Hello, Razif from Group 1. Fairuz, I hope you're well. Shima, I've got Susie. Hussein, I've got Rohani, I've got Shah, I've got Yusuf. There's so many of them. I'm so sorry if I can't mention all.
And also Fatin,
yes, of course. All right, so today, what we're going to do is that we're going to look at different ways to learn English so that it will help boost up your confidence and you're able to speak the language well mm-hmm. and to learn to love the language. And today, we're going to look at how we can learn English from songs.
Yeah.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, songs brings us back memories.
Yes,
it can be happy ones, sweet ones, and also bitter ones. So, ladies, I'm going to play you this song, and all those tuning in, please sing along if you can, if you know the song. And at the end of the song, we're going to learn how do we feel after listening to the songs. And on the aspect of English, what about English we can't learn from the song? So enjoy the music and the song.
Do you know what you're hoping for when you look behind you? There's no window.
That was a beautiful number by Daniel Ross. So listeners, I'm sure you agree with me when I say that songs helps us express our thoughts. It helps us connect and relate to our own emotions. It helps us understand the true meaning of the sentences and what lies behind those sentences. But what's important here is, what is the true message that the song is trying to get across? So I have here two of our panel guests today.
Panel guests.
Fatin as well as Siti Hazra. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm sure you went through some kind of emotions whilst listening to the song. Mm-hmm. So just share with us, how do you feel after listening to the song? What goes into your mind? Let's hear from Siti Hazra first.
Well, for me, as soon as I listened to this song from Do You Know Where You Are Going To by Diana Ross, for me, it's a very, very lovely song and very inspiring song. And also, it tells us about life, hopes, spirits, and dreams. And somehow or other, actually, it motivates me.
Okay.
That's my opinion.
Yes. All right. Thank you. What about Fatin?
I think this song is bring back my old memories.
Oh, sweet ones, I hope.
Sweet ones. Very lovely song. And I think it's about our dream. Mm-hmm. How we can achieve our dream in our life.
I see. Mm. All right. So, is there any particular area where we can learn English from this song?
Actually, there's a lot, especially dreams, just slip through our hands. Maybe some people doesn't know what does it mean, just slip through our hands. Yeah.
There again, sleep.
Sleep.
You can spell it in two ways.
Yes.
It's S-L-I-P and S-L-E-E-P.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So pronunciation is also very important because we have two identical words, right? Same pronunciation and but different spelling.
Yes.
So what does it mean here? Slip through our hands.
We let so many dreams just slip through our hands. We let the dreams go.
Yeah.
We
let the opportunity just go like that.
The opportunity.
I see. Okay. Fatin? What about you, Fatin?
I think it's about just slip through our hands is let go.
Just
let go.
Just to let go.
Just to let
okay.
go.
Okay. So honestly now, ladies, was it easy when you respond to questions? Especially in English?
It's quite difficult actually.
Yeah.
It takes some time to interpret what are we going to say.
Yeah. So what makes speaking English difficult generally, Fatin?
How you it's about sentence. How you create your sentence to good sentence and people understand what you're
trying to say.
What you're trying to say. That is so true. So listeners, I'm sure you agree with them. What makes speaking English difficult is we got to think of the right word to use.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We got to not only the right word, is it suitable?
Mm-hmm.
Is it relevant? And is it appropriate?
Appropriate
to
word.
To the theme of the conversation. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And other than words, we also get to think of using the right tenses.
Mm-hmm.
Am I right?
Yes.
Yeah. How do you use go? Do I use go or do I use went? Mm-hmm. Do I use feel or do I use feelings?
Mm-hmm.
So that is on the tenses part.
Mm-hmm.
We also got to look at the grammar part as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And also using the right preposition.
Mm-hmm.
Is it on or is it under? Is it above or is it with?
Mm-hmm.
So all this makes speaking English rather difficult. Mm-hmm. But no worries. Learning English with Zach will take you through a journey on how do you master English, not overnight.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to transform you into an English, what do you call it, specialist overnight. That's a bit too far-fetched.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a journey. We learn as it goes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, stop here for a while and coming back after this, Zach, share more about information about our topic today, learn from the song. Okay, let's continue our segment with this song, Kelly Clarkson, Since You Be Gone, only on iRadio OUM, roaming across your mind.